Rolf, Adam, thank you to be with us today at the Clean Green event.
It's a pleasure.
You are the director of EMEA Industry Sales, so you are talking about with European utilities. You're from Cisco.
That's correct.
Like other investor here, maybe I know Cisco like an internet company. Why Cisco is moving? And maybe at the beginning we can talk about Cisco. Where is Cisco now? What is your business?
So Cisco started out as a company that was producing gateways, connecting computer networks within companies to each other. And basically what we had is different systems. They were talking amongst each other, but couldn't talk to each other. And we came up with the gateway in 1986 and started to build the internet after that. And out of the machine to machine, the computer communication, over time we moved into the people communication with our collaboration, the telephony systems, the video systems, and are now also moving into the data center space. So how do you store and process data? Now, that all has been in the enterprise space, the classic IT space. And over the last 10 years, what we have seen, and smart grid is clearly one of the early movers in that space, what we have seen is a movement by industrial companies to take the industrial side, the true operation side of their business, also to the IT capabilities that we have in the enterprise IT space. And we figured, since we do have a long history and very valid experience in the enterprise IT side, we see the need for those capabilities in operations, like smart grid.
So you have maybe a less growth on the historical business, and you think that you have more more business to do with the smart grid?
The second part is definitely true. We see a vast need for professional IT skills and services and clearly hardware and infrastructure on operation side, on smart grid side, where we have legacy systems that are just not up to the task of modern networks and the Energiewende, as we came to call it now. The growth in the enterprise IT side is there, but clearly you can't compare this to 10 years ago when we were building the internet. Now everything is connected in the office space, and we do have solid market share in all those markets. It's hard to grow the business at that rate.
What is the, not the issue, but what is the ability for the utilities company to move forward and to think more about IT, as you said, and more connected people, more connected, maybe moving this industry has to move, because it's not easy. With the internet, we share some news, we share some things. When you are in a utilities company, you don't want to share some huge information.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Utilities tend to be very cautious companies, and they manage and administer a system that is roughly 100 years old, and not much has changed over those 100 years. And following the approach of never touch a running system, they are very hesitant to change it. Also, a lot of the utilities lack the financial capabilities to invest into the networks and to invest in the power plants, given the recent changes that we see in the market. And then finally, they are engineering-driven companies, and they're very proud of what they have built over the last 100 years. And they typically have built systems that are system by use case connected, meaning they didn't approach it like we did with the internet, where we try to connect everything through a coherent and consistent infrastructure. They have a business case, they have a need, and they build an infrastructure for that. And then another one, and another one, and another one. And now come we with a smart grid and say, put it all on one infrastructure, share the cost, put it up on a more professional level, and they struggle with that.
Mm-hmm. I think for them, security is important. So
absolutely.
How are you talking about this subject for them?
Absolutely. The security is important to them, and what we have in place today is actually perceived status of security, and it's more security by obscurity. It's legacy systems, legacy networks, and the only reason they have been secure in the past is that utilities were not in the focus of people's attentions. If a 15-year-old person wanted to hack a network, they hacked into the Bank of America, they hacked into NASA, but they didn't hack into a utility. Now, that has changed, and utilities see the need for more security, and the modern networks like VCell, the IP-based networks, actually are a sound foundation to establish a proper security model that is more than just limiting access to a system, which is truly the security that is in place in most of the cases today.
We can see for them that is industry transition. It's not easy to put it in on real things. What are your advice, and what kind of advice are you giving to promote this industry transition?
The way that utilities approach it in many cases is they do a pilot after a pilot after a pilot. And it's more about exploring the technology side of things rather than coming up with a vision where they want to take their business, then building an operating model, a business model around it, and finally then investing into technology. They do it the other way around. They start with the technology, test it to death, and by the time they're through with testing it, things have moved on. We can see new technology coming in. I think a good example is Master City. Master City, the green CO2 footprint neutral city, what they did was they had a very ambitious plan and then went straight to the technology selection and technology testing phase, and they never got out of it. They got stuck in the technology testing and nothing happened in Master City, unfortunately.
But do you think it's the future or it's a near future for the smart grid? It's years in some years, in some tens of years? How do you mean about that?
Not a straightforward answer. I think the smart grid is already here, but it means different things and has different development stages for different people and different countries and different companies. So if you look at Enel in Italy, they have rolled out smart meters, 30 million more than 10 years ago. They have invested massively in distribution automation. Why? Because the regulator had asked them to bring down the outage times considerably, and they figured out only with the semi-smart grid they will be able to address that issue. Obviously, countries like Germany, where we have massively dispersed distributed generation facilities, and their utilities see the need to invest into the grid because otherwise they just will not be able to manage it. And then we have other locations that basically run as a stable system, like France, where we have still the high dependency upon nuclear power plants, where the need to invest into smart grid at a larger scale beyond pilots, and with all due respect, you do have quite a number of very interesting pilots in France, but it's not yet a rollout stage. It's more the exploratory stage that we were talking about before.
How about utilities? If they are not choosing the smart grid or letting the smart grid outside of their business model, do you think that they can disappear or they can lose markets?
Part of the utility operations may well disappear. If you look at the industry transition that's going on, the lesser dependence on the large-scale power plants clearly is an issue right now financially. I think we will see a renaissance of large-scale power plants again, because in the end, we will need them for quite some time. I think the part that is at risk the most is really the distribution side of the business and the retail side of the business. Because like at the conference today where we are speaking, we have a high number of very innovative young companies on the retail side that have new technology solutions, new market approaches, new business models that are very compelling to consumers. So they're luring customers away from utilities. And the grid, the distribution network, has long been seen as a natural monopoly. But actually with the advent of distributed generation, batteries, the new technologies for managing energy, we may not need a distribution network 10, 15 years from now. There always will be a need for a network for large-scale energy users, but at the retail level, that may not be there, and utilities are having a hard time seeing that they may just fade away.
So it's we will see a new ecosystem, and they will create a new ecosystem, and do they will earn money if they are doing, if they are moving forward to create this new ecosystem?
Absolutely. I think it's still the utility space to claim, because the amount of knowledge and competences and experience in that space is unrivaled, unmatched. It's one of the most complex systems that we operate today. And it's very hard for newcomers to actually understand all the ins and outs of that business, not only from a commercial perspective, but more so from a technology perspective, and having all the interdependencies there. The true challenge for them is, as you rightly say, is creating the right ecosystem, finding IT partners they trust, maybe also new financing partners, coming up with new business models, helping them to lease part of the infrastructure to customers, also be ready to hand over part of the responsibility and the ownership of infrastructure to end customers. That's what they need to work on.
Thank you, Rolf, to have been with us today.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you.